particularly in wartime. I know. I was an American soldier in the great race war against Japan. Before I left to go to the Pacific, we were given an indoctrination course on how to tell our exquisite allies, the Chinese, from our brutish enemy, the Japanese. So on a stage like this, there was a life-size cutout of a naked Chinese youth, and there was another one of a Japanese. The Chinese was tall, slim, and well-proportioned. The Japanese was bandy-legged, buck-toothed, subhuman. These details were pointed out very seriously to us by an information officer with a pointer. But the principal difference, he announced, as you can plainly see, is the pubic hair. The Japanese is thick and wiry, while the Chinese is straight and silky. I fear that I alone raised my hand to ask what sly strategies we were to use to determine friend from foe.
The British still read, I think, more per capita than the Americans do. And they're also rather loyal. If they've ever liked anything by you in America, you must have one hit bestseller after the other, and if you don't have it for a couple of books, you are counted out. Very Darwinian, The Great Republic. Well, the serious novel seems to be pretty much at an end as far as the general public goes. Television is now the central fact in most lives. So I would think that the great line of literature, which really sort of started with George Eliot, I suppose, and reached a peak with Proust and Henry James, is pretty much at an end. I love it when they go on about, oh, there are no great writers today. Well, of course they're great writers. They're just no great readers. You can't have a literature without people who read it.
Yeah, it's very true.
That is a bit of wisdom I learned 40 years ago on television. When you think it's really gone very boringly, and then you watch it, which I don't do anymore, but if you do watch it, it isn't that boring. Or you may have thought it was very good, and it wasn't that good either. It's television. It just goes. There's nothing to choose. On that note, I leave it.